Why is there a comb here? Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to the much and highly requested Inca Roads by Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention off of their album One Size Fits All, released in 1975. You guys have overwhelmingly asked for this song, mentioned this song. I told you guys I was not giving up on Frank Zappa. I would love to listen to a little bit more from him. I don't know much about him. I'm here to learn. I know he has hundreds of albums. And while I can't guarantee that we will be able to get to all of them, I would at least like to educate myself a little bit, because I know so many of you have a great respect for the man, for the music, for really everything. And like I've mentioned before, I've seen interviews with him, and he seems like a pretty cool guy. I just don't really know much about the music, so that's what we're here to do today. You are more than welcome to join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. I hope that you're having a great day, a beautiful night, wonderful evening, whatever time it is, wherever you are. I just hope that it's the best that it can be. Let's do it. This is Inca Roads by Frank Zappa and the Mothers of Invention.
dead of the hickle bomb. I'm somewhere around the dead of the hickle bomb. I'm somewhere around the dead. The Indians first on the bell. Carve up the hill.
I actually don't even know where to start. I legitimately have no idea where do you want me to start with that. Okay. Let's talk about me for a second. I don't want to be selfish, but because I want everyone to understand, okay? So one thing that I generally do not like, and I think one reason why I've been hesitant to an extent to move forward and explore Frank Zappa, not only just because of all the sheer amount of music I have to explore anyway on the channel, but because personal taste, besides a few cases, I don't really like comedy injected into my music. I don't really like to laugh while I listen. Like I said, besides a few cases here and there, I'm just not really into like comedy rock or I don't know what you would call it. You know, like for example, Primus. Like they have it's a very unique sound and I get it. I do understand. It's just not my flavor personally. You know, it's like how people like mint chocolate ice cream. Hey, it's not my thing. I get it. Everyone has a thing, but it's not my thing. This is almost like mint chocolate ice cream, or at least this genre from what the few songs that I've heard from Frank Zappa. Now, one thing that I do enjoy about this song in particular, and I have definitely heard it on previous songs I've heard from Zappa, is, yes, it still has those comedy elements, you know, the voices and the singing, and even some of the instrumental runs and passages in the song still definitely have that. But it's upheld by such high musicianship that I'm still enjoying and impressed by it, you know? And yes, there are moments where it's over the top with, you know, that tone, but it doesn't necessarily bother me, you know? I feel like because the instrumentation and the way that the song is structured is so well put together that it just feels like a fun song with some comedic nuances. It doesn't feel like a song that's like trying to make you laugh or feels forced or just feels weird for the sake of being weird. I don't really care about that because that's almost like image to me, you know, if you're just being weird for the sake of being weird. Now, if the weirdness comes through in your music and it comes through good, then that's awesome. That's what I want. So with Inca Roads, I got that from the just pummeling drums, which were just really, really raving throughout. The bass work, oh my gosh, fantastic. The guitar, especially the guitar, in that middle slowed down section, which you guys know that I'm going to mention because that's my thing. I love slowed down, heavy groove, heavy rhythm, and just go off in there. And that's what they did. They brought you into that slow, deep groove. Big transition, by the way. It was a big shift in and out of it. And that middle section with the guitar solo, very nice. I like how the drums steadily built up their pace, steadily built up. Actually, really everything did in there. And then, like I said, it got back into sections and moments where the song kind of bounced around like a cartoon, to be honest. But at the same time, the musicianship was so high that it was enjoyable each time and every time that it did happen. Also, I totally forgot to mention it at the beginning, but this album cover, it's kind of cool. Even from the very opening, it does have a very unique sound to it, right? I don't want to say funny, but it's got a unique and somewhat weird sound to it, I guess you could say. But at the same time, it sounds kind of cool. I like these spacey sounds that are taking place around us while this nice groove is going on. And the singing. So the singing. George Duke is singing on this one. Now, his voice reminds me of, like, singers and artists that I've grown up around. Vocal-wise, I'm drawn to this. Vocal-wise, I was very surprised, but I really like that. It's interesting. I like that little skit that kind of happened there, but I also like the way that the music came back into it. It didn't go on too long. It wasn't like this huge thing. It was just kind of like a little inserting comedic timing. Musically, it played along right with it, and then they jump back into it, and when they jump back, they jump back. And pacing. Pacing is really unique in this one. Just the starting and the stopping and the awkward pausing in different syllables and then continuing that syllable but on another line of the melodic passage. I think that is just one of the coolest things about the song. Really, it is a really cool song, and I get that. But like the vocal pacing and the vocal delivery is also top notch. Not just, you know, tonally and the actual singing, but just the way that it's broken up and spaced. Let me get some moments of musical levity here that are used to transition between sections. But that. I mean, do I really need to even say anything about the next few minutes starting there? I mean, honestly, you guys know what I'm gonna say. Do I need to say it? Because I'm not going to. You already know what I'm going to say. It's perfect. That's awesome. That's good. And I like. Yes, please. More of that. At the same time, that section is made more powerful because of everything that surrounds it on both ends of it. Because of the fast-paced and the comedic movements that are going on before, because of the structure changes and the transitions that are very, you know, obtuse that come after, that's what makes that section so powerful because it's so conventional in this playground of musicianship. Like, literally, what else am I say? And then that. Zappa playing the guitar on this one, so obviously, I mean, that solo is just, that's really out of this world. But I really enjoy what everyone else is doing as well throughout. Like I said, the drumming really picks up. The bass is so, so present, and it's so strong in the mix especially. And I don't even know what time signature this is, but it gives me a little bit of a headache. And you have some really nice keys as well going on. Ruth Underwood on the vibes, the marimba and extra percussion. I believe that she had played on Montana, which we listened to, you know, what was it? Probably been a year now since we listened to that one. Like right here. this is a really nice, that's a really nice section between Chester Thompson, by the way, and Ruth. Chester Thompson, touring drummer for Genesis. I'm just saying, if anything, if you could say anything about Zappa, he knows how to bring the right people together. He's like Donald Fagen and Walter Becker, Steely Dan. Knows how to bring the right people in, do what they're going to do. Now, I am curious because this is the first time that I've heard of the Mothers of Invention. So I'm just looking up on Wikipedia really quick. I don't know if this is like a band that he works with every so often. I don't know if this is like his main band. I don't know if this was like his first band that he's ever worked with, or if it's like a rotating kind of thing going on. Honestly, I have no idea. It just says they're an American rock band. And I'm not going to sit here and go through every single thing on it, but I'll let you guys fill me in. And then getting to the lyrics, which honestly I almost forgot. Did a vehicle come from somewhere out there just to land in the Andes? Was it round and did it have a motor, or was it something different? Sure was different. I ain't seen nothing like that in my entire life. I like how they use the voices to fill in this part and to answer those questions. Whose python boot is that? That ain't my... What? Why don't you sharpen it then? Little round ball, I couldn't. That white can't do nothing, Jesus. Wait a minute. I like even like the accents that they kind of play around with. Like I said, that, for me personally, that's cool. I'm cool with that. Then he repeats the first lines. Find a place to park, park itself. Or did someone build a place to leave a space for such a thing to land? Sounds like aliens to me. Did a vehicle come from somewhere out there? Did a vehicle come from somewhere out there? Did the Indians first on the bill carve up the hill? Did a booger bear come from somewhere out there just to land in the Andes? Was she round? Did she have motor? Guacamole queen, guacamole queen, guacamole queen. That was really funny, by the way, when he said that in the song. At the Armadillo in Austin, Texas, her aura. Or did someone build a place or leave a space for Chester's thing to land? Chester's thing on Ruth. I'm assuming Chester Thompson and Ruth. I don't know. Listen, it's about aliens. Am I wrong? I don't think so. Anyways, I did like the song, and I would even say that this is my favorite song that I've heard from Frank Zappa so far. Peaches, I liked it, but it's not like a favorite. Montana, I liked it, but it's not really like a favorite. Inca Roads, I liked it. Still not a favorite, but definitely stronger and more enjoyable for myself. Compared to the other songs, even though, like I said, those are good as well. I'm not saying that they're bad. This one was fun to listen to for me. I like how it felt like expanded, because that was one thing that I didn't like about Peaches, is that it was maybe just a little too quick in its movements. I wanted something a little more out of it. This, I'm getting more out of it. And I'm actually going to listen to this again, probably tonight, just because with songs like this, one, I want to listen to it twice, but I feel like I'm going to enjoy it more on my second, third, and fourth listen. And I'm going to look for a live version as well, because with Zappa, I would like to see what he does on the stage. Of course, I would love to know what you guys think. Join me on Twitter. Join me in the comments down below. Thank you for recommending this one as well. I don't know if I do that enough. I need to thank you guys more for actually recommending me the songs, because, like I always say, you guys help me find some good stuff. You can join me on Patreon if you like, but you don't have to. You can just relax. Just sit there. Just watch the videos. What more could I ask? Thank you guys so much. Hope you have a fantastic day. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.